In this video, I'm going to explain how to estimate the problem of squeezing that can happen in tunnels in very soft rocks. Typically, the rock is shale, or it can be mudstone, something related to fine particles. So in this case, you will see the squeezing because the rock is so soft, it will be squeezed inside the tunnel. Because of these stresses acting on that tunnel. So these are the stresses, right? So the tunnel will look kind of like this. So all these parts will actually go in the tunnel. Okay, so to do that, we're going to look at this empirical chart where we have the ratio between rock mass strength and in situ stresses. So basically, we can estimate all these problems when we look at the ratio between stresses acting inside the tunnel and the strength of the rock. And then this will give you some idea about strain, so how much it's going to be, we're going to have there, right? So let's look at this example when we have a tunnel that will be excavated at a depth of 14 meters in a flish. So flish, it's bearing planes, and the estimated rock mass of this material, it's pretty low, so it's probably like very jointed and soft rock mass. And we're going to estimate if there is going to be squeezing or not if we excavate at this depth, which is 44 meters. So you will see in this formula we need to find rock mass strength and in situ stress. So we can start with stress. So in this case, rock mass strength is going to be is given to us. Rock mass strength, it's pretty low. It's 0.17 MPa. And now let's estimate the in situ stress. So typically with in situ stress, we use a formula as unit weight times h, right? So where h is the depth. So if this is, we have tunnel here, and this is going to be h here, and this rock mass will have unit weight of, I don't know, typically is given, but in this case we have no information. If we don't have information, we'll go with the average value, which is given in this formula that you should probably already remember, 0.027. So we assume that unit weight of average rock is 27 kilonewtons per cubic meters. So what I'm doing, I use it as 0.027 so that I can get my answer in megapascals. So this is a very commonly used formula, so you can find it in any textbooks on rock mechanics. So, and that will give you 119 MPa. So that will be the stress sigma 1 acting on this tunnel, 119 MPa. So now we're going to estimate this ratio. So, which is strength of rock mass divided by this the stress. It has a slightly different letter P. Usually for stress we use sigma, but I'm not sure why they use P. Okay, so it will have 0.17 divided by 119. And that will give us the answer of 0.14. So now we look at the chart, and then we see where we have 114. We have it somewhere here. So this value will be 0.14. All right, so now we're going to see what is going to be the strain. And the strain is actually a little bit greater than 5, right? Here is 5. So say close to 5, but a little bit more than 5. So you'll see that for strain between 5 and 10, that's what we have. So if we have this much strain, so we can assume that there will be very severe squeezing problems. So in fact, this tunnel may actually even collapse at some point, some part of the tunnel, because of this very severe squeezing problem. So that's how you do this estimation based on the chart and on the strength of rock mass. Thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye.